हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इकोसिस्टम. फर्स्ट द टर्म इकोसिस्टम वाज कॉइन्ड बाय एजी टांसले इन द 1935. अकॉर्डिंग टू हिम द टर्म इकोसिस्टम वाज कंसिस्ट ऑफ द टू ग्रीक वर्ड namely eco and system. Eco is environment, eco means environment, and system means complex coordinated unit. Simply we can say here the ecosystem is nothing but the complex coordinated unit of nature is called as the ecosystem. Ecosystem is consist of the biotic and abiotic factors. It means it is consist of the living beings and non-living things that collectively form a natural unit, what we call the ecosystems. There are various examples of ecosystem, namely we can say here it is a small as drop of water, pinch of soil, and as large as the world. So why the drop of water is called ecosystem? Because if we analyze the drop of water, there in which we find some organisms and non-living components. So that's why a drop of water is also the ecosystems. Pinch of soil, if we analyze the soil, there are in which also we find some organisms and the non-living components. And hence it is as small as the drop of water, pinch of soil, and as large as the world. It is an interacting systems. So why it is called as the interacting systems? System where it is a interacting system where biotic and abiotic factors interact to produce exchange of material between living and non-living factors. If we see the forest ecosystem, we can understand why the ecosystem is called as the interacting systems. In forest ecosystem, there are various organisms like plants, the animals like goat and the lion in a forest ecosystem. And some microorganisms that what we call the decomposers. In a group of organisms of a ecosystem, the first is a plant which provide a food to goat, and goat become a food for the animals like a lion. After dead and decaying part of plants and dead and decaying parts and their waste of the animals is converted into the organic and inorganic substances. So such inorganic substances like the CO2, H2O, NO3, nitrate, nitrite, NO2, NO3, some other inorganic substances are reused by the plants. Hence it is an interacting system where the biotic and abiotic factors are interactive produce exchange of material between living and non-living factors. There is exchange of material takes place between the living and non-living things or factors. That's why it is called as the interacting systems. So how can define the ecosystems? Ecosystem is a natural unit of plants, natural unit of organisms like plants, animals and microorganisms. And they are functioning together with their non-living environment. Such a natural unit of nature is called as the ecosystems. Now basically the ecosystem is consist of the living and living organisms and non-living environments. So that's why they are that's why we can see here the ecosystem is the natural unit of organism functioning together with the non-living environment is called the ecosystem. Ecosystem is the structural and functional unit of ecology, where the living organism interact with each other and surrounding the surrounding environment. In other words, an ecosystem is a chain of interactions between organisms and their environment. So there are various examples of the ecosystem, that what we call pond, lake, river, stream, forest, grassland, town, city, are the best examples of the ecosystem. If we see these different examples of the ecosystem, in each ecosystem there is different biotic and biotic factors, and accordingly there are various type of the ecosystem. Then structures of an ecosystems. Structurally the ecosystem is consist of biotic and abiotic factors. So this is structures. Abiotic factors, non-living component of ecosystem is called as abiotic factors or the component. Non-living factors of the ecosystem is called the abiotic component. It includes air, water, soil, light, temperature, and etc. Whereas the biotic factor, living components, living factors of the ecosystem is called as the biotic component, and they are furtherly classified into producers, consumers, producers, consumers, and decomposers. Then abiotic factors. So how can define abiotic factor? Non-living components of environment is called as the abiotic components. It includes air, water, soil, light, temperature, pressure, climate, minerals, etc. All the biotic factors of the ecosystems are directly depend upon abiotic factors. So this is regarding what abiotic factors. Then next is the biotic factors or biotic component. Living factors, living component of the environment are called as the biotic component. They are furtherly divided into three groups, namely producers, consumers, and decomposers. It includes plants, animals, and microorganisms. The first biotic component, that what we call the producers. So what are producers? Producers, the organism which carried out photosynthesis by using CO2 and H2O in the presence of light to produce food, that what we call the producers. Producers are the organisms. Producers are organisms which carry photosynthesis. Such organisms are called as the producers. Simply we can say here, the photosynthetic organisms are called as the producers. Producers are plants, maybe green algae, phytoplanktons, are the producers. And basically, they are plants. Producers are autotrophs. Why they are called as autotrophs? Because they produce their own food from inorganic substances like CO2, H2O, in the presence of light and chlorophyll pigment. That's why it is called as autotrophs. It includes algae, plants, and some bacteria. Autotrophs, organism, the plants are autotrophs. Why? Because they produce their own food from the inorganic substances like CO2, H2O, in the presence of light and chlorophyll pigments. So that's why it is also called autotrophs. They are not depend upon other organism for their food. So that's why they are called as the autotrophs. But the producers are autotroph. The portion of energy synthesized is used by the producers for growth and its survival. And the remaining energy is stored for future use. So this is regarding what, just we can say here, the producers are photosynthetic organisms. They are autotrophs. There are various producers like algae, plants, and bacteria. They found different producers are different producer in different ecosystem. Different ecosystem. If you see the grassland ecosystem, the grass is a producer of the grassland ecosystem. If you see the pond ecosystem, there will be the producers of pond ecosystems is algae and phytoplanktons and etc. So what I want to say is the producers are different in different ecosystem. That's why we can see here algae, plants, and bacteria are the producers. Next, biotic component of the ecosystem, that what we call the consumers. All the consumers are animals. So these are the animals. All the consumers are animals. So how can define the consumers? Organism which eat the other organisms are called the consumers. Are the organism which depend upon other organism for their food, that what we call the consumers. Consumers are animals. All the consumers are animals. They are not plants. They are animals. There are various animals as we seen in a picture, that what we call rabbit, deer, cow, elephant, fox, wolf, snail, fish, frog, lizard, cat, lion, and etc. They are called heterotrophs. Why they are called as heterotrophs? Because they are depend upon other organism for their food. So that's why they are called as heterotrophs. But plants are autotrophs. Producers are autotrophs. Why? Because they produce their own food from inorganic substances in the presence of light in chlorophyll pigment. They are not producers. They are not produce their own food, but depend upon other organisms, on other organisms for their food. They are furtherly classified into three or more group, namely primary consumers, secondary consumers, and tertiary consumers. First, the primary consumers. What is primary consumers? Primary consumers, the organisms which eat the plant, the organism which eat the plant, such organisms are called as primary consumers. There are various primary consumers are there. Namely, in each ecosystem, there are different primary consumers in different ecosystems. In pond ecosystems, the consumers may be zooplanktons, In a grassland ecosystem, the consumer may be rabbit, deer, or goat, and etc. So what I want to say here, the primary consumers are different in different ecosystems. They are also called herbivores. They prefer a plant-like food materials. That's why they are called as the herbivores. So for example, goat, deer, elephant. So these are the examples of the forest ecosystem. These are the primary consumers of the forest ecosystem. But zooplanktons are the grasshoppers. Grasshoppers are the examples of grassland ecosystem, cropland ecosystem, and etc. So this is primary consumers. So these are the examples of the primary consumers like goat, deer, and cow is grazing in grassland ecosystems. All the herbivores are grazing in the grassland ecosystem. Okay, this is regarding what the primary consumers. Then secondary consumers. What is secondary consumers? The organism which eat the herbivores. Such organisms are called as the secondary consumers. Or the plant eating organisms are called as secondary consumers. The organism which eat the herbivores, such organisms are called as the secondary consumers. Secondary consumers are primary carnivores. They may be carnivores or omnivores. They may be secondary consumers may be carnivores or omnivores. There are various examples that what we call the fish in pond ecosystems, lizards in grassland ecosystems, dog, fox, wolf, small birds are the secondary consumers in the forest ecosystem. Here the secondary consumers are different in different ecosystems. So these are some examples of the, what I'm going to say here, the secondary consumers. Crocodiles and dog, wolf, jackal, fox are what I'm going to say the secondary consumers. Secondary consumers. Okay. So this is secondary consumers. Then tertiary consumers. So what is tertiary consumers? The organisms which kill and eat. Such organisms are called the tertiary consumers. Tertiary consumers are pure carnivores. They are also called carnivores. There are various examples like hawk, lioness, tiger, or etc. are the tertiary consumers. If you see in a picture, we can guess they are predators. The tertiary consumers are the predators. Why? They kill and then eat. So that's why we can define the organism which kill and eat. Such organisms are called as the tertiary consumers. So this is hawk hunting the deer. Means it hunt first and then eat. Such organisms are called as the tertiary consumers. Then here, the lioness hunting the zebra. Lioness hunting the zebra. So this is regarding what I'm going to say here, the tertiary consumers. The consumer as a one of the group of the biotic factors. Then next group of organisms of the ecosystem, that what we call the decomposers. So what are the decomposers? Decomposers are nothing but the dead body of plants, animals, and their waste. Degrading organisms are called as the decomposers. So how can define decomposers? Dead body of plants, animals, and their waste, degrading organisms are called the decomposers. Organisms which break the dead part and waste of the plants and animals, such organisms are called as the decomposers. Decomposers are also called deasers. So there are various type of decomposers, as we seen in image, that what we call the snail in aquatic ecosystem, slug, millipedes, centipedes, and earthworms, mite, spring tail. So there are various the organisms like fungus, bacteria, are the examples of the decomposers. What they did in the what they do in the ecosystem, the first they secrete the enzyme outside the body and convert the dead and decaying part part of plants and animals and their waste into organic one. Then organic organic material is converted into inorganic materials. Hence they are called as the decomposer. And this inorganic material is reutilized plant and reutilized by the plant. So that's why the decomposers are very play important role in the ecosystems. Well, what they do first, they secrete the enzymes and digest the dead organism into smaller molecules. Into what? Smaller molecules. After taking these molecules are absorbed by the deasers, and after taking energy, they release molecules to the environment as chemical to be reused by the plants. It means the whatever the organic materials of dead part of plants and animals that convert into inorganic substances like NO2, NO3, CO2, H2O, and these and certain minerals are reutilized by the plants. So that's why the decomposer has the immense importance in the ecosystem. So this is just the general structures of the ecosystem that is consist of biotic and abiotic factors.